Welcome back. In the introduction to business simulation today, we will cover three topics. First of all, we're going to start a motivation for business simulation. We will also describe a game show example as our introductory example. I will also introduce X-Risk software, which is the software we will use to carry out a business simulation. Simulation is one of the most frequently employed management science techniques. It is a method for learning about a real system by experimenting with a model that represents the system. In other words, a simulation model is a model that imitates a real-life situation. It is typically used to model random processes that are too complex to be solved by analytical methods. Let's look at one illustration of business simulation. Please pause this lecture video and check out the airport simulation created by Telemus on YouTube. Please take note that this 1 minute video does not have any sound. Over here, Telemus, the company who ran the simulation, created a busy airport based on passengers' behavior in the airport. There are many factors that require careful considerations. For example, is the simulated baggage system capable of handling all baggage in time? How about the waiting time of the passengers at a security checkpoint, the gates, and the baggage claim area? There are a lot of randomness involved in these considerations, as the amount of time taken for each passenger at each stage is likely to be different from each other. Flights are frequently delayed or arrive early, and there may be mechanical or any other technical issues for planes, especially older ones. I hope you are convinced that this is an extremely complicated and sophisticated problem to simulate. The same goes for many other real-life applications. For this course, students are not expected to work on a problem of this scale, but we are going to discuss how the concept of simulations apply to different business fields and how the concept of randomness in real-life applications may affect our final outcome. To build a simulation model, we will have to use some tools. We are not going to use some fancy tools that involve animations like those in the airport simulation for our class, but the tools discussed here will be sufficient for us to get some ideas on what simulation is about. We will use some native Excel functions. We will also spend a lot of time discussing at-risk, which is an Excel as-in. More details on using at-risk can be found on our course site. Let's take a look at the introductory example for this module, game show simulation. On a game show, contestants win fabulous prizes for answering questions. If the contestant gets the answer correct, then the winnings are obtained by multiplying the prize with the bonus multiplier. So X is the winning, and P is the prize, B is the bonus multiplier. The winning, X, is equal to P multiplied by B. The prize, P, is random and uniformly distributed on the interval between $1,000 and $3,000. That means it is equal likely to be for the prize, P, to be $2,000 or $2,500 or $2,537. They are all equally likely. The bonus multiplier B has a discrete uniform distribution on the interval 1, 2, 3, all the way to 20, so that it can take on the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to 20 with equal probability. That means the likelihood of a B taking the value of 1 is 1 over 20, and the likelihood of B taking value of 20 is also 1 over 20. The question for us to consider here is, what is the probability that the winnings, which is X, is going to be at least $20,000? There are several methods to calculate this probability of having a winning of at least $20,000. This probability can be computed analytically using calculus. This problem is challenging but doable. The exact probability is about 47.6%. A second method is to play this game a very large number of times, say 10,000 times. Out of these 10,000 times, how many of the games where the event actually happens? That means how many times the winning is indeed more than $20,000? The proportion can be used to estimate this probability. The problem with this approach is that it's extremely time-consuming and also very boring to do. The third method is to develop a business simulation model. Try to play the game 10,000 times without physically playing the game. And we try to find an estimate of the winning probability. I'm going to show you how we can simulate this game show problem using two different methods. The first one using Excel native functions, and the second one using at-risk functions. As shown in the upper right corner of the spreadsheet, using 100 games, I estimate the probability to be 44%, which is quite close to the true analytical solution of 47.6%. One thing to notice is that every time I press F9, this spreadsheet is refreshed. Another 100 games are simulated, and the probability will be slightly different, but shouldn't be too far away from the true solution of 47.6%. Let's start with the first approach of simulating this problem using native Excel functions. The first native Excel function is RandBetween, which takes two arguments, A and B. This function returns an integer between A and B with equal likelihood. Whenever this function is used, a new random number is generated. For example, if you try to generate a number from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with equal likelihood, you can use RandBetween 1, 6. Here we use RandBetween to simulate a scenario where we toss a fair die 10 times. Column A represents the tosses from 1 to 10. Column B represents their corresponding outcome using RandBetween. In column B, we enter RandBetween 1, 6 because each face of the die has the same likelihood to occur. The next function is Rand, which does not have to take any argument. Rand, open bracket, close bracket, returns a real valued number, not integers, between 0 and 1, with equal chance. That is the same as saying simulating a uniform random number between 0 and 1. We are probably more interested in simulating a real number uniformly between 1 and 10. To do that, we can use this formula based on Rand, that is 1 plus 9 multiplied Rand. More generally, to simulate a real number between any A and B, we can use A plus B minus A multiplied Rand, or the smaller number plus the difference between the two numbers multiplied Rand. Another commonly used Excel function is the if function. The if function runs a logical test. If the test is true, the if function returns one value. And if the test is false, this if function returns another value. We can use the if function to simulate toss outcome of an unfair coin. This unfair coin has 30% chance of showing a tail and a 70% chance of showing a head. We would like to print tails when tails show up with 30% probability, and print heads when heads show up with 70% of the probability. This can be done using the if function. The if function takes three arguments. So the first argument represents the condition, that's rent less than 0.3. The second argument represents the value to return when this condition is met, and that's going to be tails. And the last argument represents the value to return when the condition is not met, and that's going to be when rent more than 0.3, we want to return heads. Let's take a look at how we can simulate a game show using these Excel functions we just learned. Column A represents the index of the games. Column B represents the price P, that is a real number between 1,000 and 3,000. To do that, we use the formula we just learned,
1,000 plus 2,000 multiplied rand. Column C is the bonus multiplier that is an integer between 1 and 20. We will use RandBetween function to do that. Column D, the winnings, is just a product of B and C. In column E, we would have to check whether each winning has met the condition of more than $20,000. To do that, we will use the if function. The first argument will be a logical test to see whether the winning in column D is more than $20,000. If it's indeed more than 20K, we will return 1. If the winning is less than 20K, we will return 0. We are very close to find a solution. Now we would sum up all the number of games with winnings of more than $20,000. That would be summing up all the ones in column E. You may notice that the games with less than $20,000 winnings will not be included, as their column E is simply a zero. We count the total number of games played here using count function. The proportion of games with more than $20,000 winning is calculated in cell I3. For this particular illustration, it's about 44%. Now, please pause this video and try to simulate this game show using Excel on your own. Your estimate may not be the same as mine, but it should be all quite close to the true analytical solution of 47.6%. You may have noticed that the simulation results obtained using Excel functions change every time we refresh the spreadsheet. It's not easy to track the simulation results. Rand and RandBetween are useful functions, but are usually unable to handle many of the complex business problems. In this class, we will use a simulation software called At-Risk to help model more complicated business problems. At-Risk is much easier than using the native Excel functions. There are many other similar simulation software that are also able to track simulation results and provides graphs and tables for analysis. At-Risk and other simulation software allow us to see what variables or factors may affect the final outcome the most, and how they may interact with each other. This information is valuable to identify risks to take or to avoid, and to allow us to make informed decisions under uncertainty. At-Risk is a powerful simulation tool built in the Excel environment. It generates and tracks many possible scenarios and provides summary results for better decision making. Here are several ways to access At-Risk. You can use remote access to the computer lab. You can use any computers in the lab. You could also download the At-Risk version on your own computer and use the trial version. And certainly you can also purchase a full version, though that's not necessary. I also trust that you know how to load At-Risk in Excel using the instructions provided on our course site. Let's take a look at how to set up this problem using At-Risk. Always be sure to check to see whether At-Risk has already loaded in Excel. Using At-Risk to simulate business scenarios, there are usually 5 steps. In step 1, we identify variables that influence the final outcomes and use At-Risk and Excel functions to generate these variables. In our game show simulation, these variables include price, bonus multiplier, winning, and also a logical test to see whether the winning is more than $20,000. I'd highly recommend you giving these variables easy to understand names, for example, price, bonus, winnings, instead of A, B, C, or X, Y, Z for all variables. Because price has a uniform distribution between $1,000 and $3,000, in At-Risk, we use risk uniform function to simulate it. Bonus is also uniformly distributed, but has to be an integer, so we use risk int uniform to simulate it. Some of the commonly used At-Risk functions are also summarized later in this video and also provided on our course site. Cell B4 and B6 can be defined using the native functions we just talked about a few minutes ago. Now we complete step one. In step two, we define our output cell. It could be one or it could be multiple outputs in at-risk. This way, at-risk would understand which variable we are interested in tracking and analyzing. For this particular example, it's going to be cell B6. I first click on cell B6 and then click on output on the top ribbon. In step 3, we set a number of iterations or scenarios that we would like to simulate. For this game show example, I set the iteration to 10,000 times and leave the number of simulation to 1. Step 4, we run the simulations by clicking on the simulate button on the very top. Depending on the specification of your computer, the amount of time to complete the simulations may vary drastically. So it may be a good practice to reduce the number of iterations to a smaller number, say 100 times, before you start running the full simulations of 10,000 times. After the simulations are all completed, we generate and interpret the reports in step 5, that's also the last step. Many times, a graph with summary statistics on the right will pop up. If not, click on Explore, Distribution, and then Automatic. Alternatively, click on Explore, then Browse Results to see this. This graph and summary statistics created are very useful for decision making. You could explore more by clicking on Explore Reports on the very top. Out of those 10,000 iterations, the output cell B6 takes the value of 1 for a total of 4,770 times. This means that in 10,000 games, the winning exceeded $20,000 for a total of 4,770 times. Therefore, the probability is 47.7%, very close to the analytical solution of 47.6%. Note that your simulation results will most likely to be different from mine, but should be quite close. From this example, we can see that there are generally four components in a simulation model. The variable or variables of interest are the outputs that are determined by the inputs. There are two types of inputs, controllable inputs and probabilistic inputs. Controllable inputs are deterministic, and their values are determined by the decision makers. Probabilistic inputs are random, and their values can only be generated by random number generators. This is where we rely on the RAND, RandBetween functions, or the at-risk functions to supply necessary values. The inputs and outputs are connected through a mathematical or logical expressions that describe the relationships between them. For our game show example, the rule of a game, the range of the prize, and the range of a bonus multiplier are all decided by the game show host. They are controllable inputs, but not random. The outcome of the prize, the bonus, multipliers are all random and generated by random number generators. Once we have all the inputs, both controllable inputs and probabilistic inputs, the winnings can be calculated by multiplying the prize and the bonus multiplier together. Finally, the output of interest is the probability of winning more than $20,000. There are a lot more useful resources provided on the Palisade website. Here are some highly recommended short video tutorials on how to use at-risk for simulations. Please be sure to watch them. Just a quick reminder that the quick start tutorials and some commonly used at-risk functions are all posted on our course site. This concludes this introductory video for business simulation.